Now that we have our layout already set up, what I want to do today is to bring in the LaraTrust package so that it can manage our roles, permissions, and that's what's going to power this admin panel. LaraTrust is just another package that is kind of like the Laravel Spades package, where it holds all the relationships between the roles and the permissions, and it sets you up with the users. I have found that I actually like this one better than I do with the Spady one. The documentation is really solid. Everything works very similarly. It just feels much simpler. So I'm excited to show you how this one works. Works pretty much the same way, but we're going to use it within our project. Something cool that it does too is it works with the Teams feature so that you can set up Teams to have the same sort of functionality with this package as well. And I think that's a pretty cool thing to do. Let's go over to the installation and we are going to just basically take it step by step. So the first thing that we want to do is we want to require the package. Now in here, I am just going to open up a terminal. Because I'm using sail, I want to do sail, and then I'll paste in that composer command, let it run. Okay, great. Now it also comes with a configuration file that we can publish. So I'm going to go ahead and copy this so that we can have that. And then we can also tweak it to our needs. For now, let's close that and let's go over to the config file and we can see what that configuration file looks like. It has a morph map relationship that we could use, but the default is set to false and we're just going to leave it like that. It also defines which checker you want to use. So by default, it is the user. The role is also by default. And there's also some caching in here too, which is pretty cool. So if we need to set that up, then we can do that here too with an expiration time. Then the model that it is using for the user model is at models user, which is correct. That's where our user model is. If we go down, these are the models that it's going to give us, which is a role model and a permission model. If we were setting up Teams, we could have a Teams model as well in here. Now, these are the tables that it's going to be giving us by default, which is roles, permissions, Teams if we were using it, role user, permission role. And like I said, if you're used to using Spades Laravel permissions, then this is all going to look very similar to it. We also have the foreign keys, which is connecting all of those tables together. So the users to the permissions, users to roles, permissions to roles, to users, etc. That's what that is pretty much doing. The other thing is it has middleware. By default, it is set to true. And there is some error handling on here, which we don't really have to worry too much about at this time. But if you wanted to configure anything in there, this is where you would do it. And here you could also customize some of your team's configuration files. Right now we have this set to permissions as gates. We are going to keep this as false for now. I don't remember if we're changing it. We'll get to that when we get to that, but this is where you can basically just give access using permissions. Now, one of the cool things about this package also is that it has its own panel. When we get to the end of the series, we'll just take a brief look at it. But for now, just know that it does have a panel and so that none of these settings for a panel are going to really affect us at all because we're not going to be using the panel. We're going to be using admin LTE to just be our styling and just handle that. But I do think it's cool that it is built into that. If you wanted to use that, it is optional. Create permissions, true, roles, restrictions, etc. This is the configuration file. Now, the next step is to do config clear if the, for whatever reason, the configuration file didn't show up, but that's what you would do to use it. And again, if we needed to change anything in there, we would run it before this next step, which is to run the setup command, which will take care of publishing our migrations, our models, and anything else that we pretty much need. So I'm going to go ahead and run this command. Well, the first question is asking us, do we want to proceed with creating the migration? I'm going to go ahead and say yes. It's been created. We have a role model and a permission model, and then we should have our migrations as well. So let's check that out first. Here you see we have a new file, which does hold our roles, permissions, our role user relationships, permission user. These are all of our relationships. So this is already good. Really, we don't have to touch anything in here unless you wanted to configure something very configurable, but it does at least give you access to it so you can do it pretty easily. The next thing I want to take a look at is our new model, which is the role model. And it's very simple. All it has is a public property that is guarded, meaning whatever fields we put in it, we will just be able to fill it in. Same thing with the permission model. We now have that accessible to us in case we wanted to customize anything with the roles and permissions. And we are going to be using this a little bit later to do something. But for now, just know that we do have it here. The next thing that we will need to do is to grab the trait. And this trait we are going to put in our user model. And what this will do is let the app know that we have a roles and permissions package that we want to use for our users to leverage their roles and permissions. From here, we can go to the user model, and then we can just add that to the end of this list here. I don't think it can find it yet, which is fine. I'll go grab it from the documentation. Then I'll just paste it there. We'll save that. Next thing, we can do composer dump autoload, and that's fine. We don't really need to do that just yet, but we can also run the migrations. What I want to do is I want to set it up so that we can have a seeder that will give us a nice little setup for configuring how we want these roles and permissions to work initially. I believe it's under migrations, maybe not. Let's go to... I don't remember where it is. Let me just do a search for it. Seeder. To get our seeder up and running, what we can do is run this command, and this command will generate a seeder for us. So let's go ahead and grab that. So the seeder has been created successfully. Let's go and take a quick look at it. So this is really nice. It's already set up the seeder for us, and what it's doing is creating some commands to print some information, and it's grabbing the information from the config file of the Lara Trust seeder. We'll publish this seeder config file in a minute, but for right now, just know that this is the seeder. It is looping over the roles model. It is adding a display name, description, etc. And then it's printing a command info where it says creating role, and then it's printing the name of the role, and then it's doing the same thing for permissions, and then it's syncing the roles to the permissions, basically creating new users to attach to those roles, or creating new users to attach those new roles to. So to print that config file, I'm going to copy this. We're going to go up here to the terminal, and I can get rid of this PHP here. Go ahead and publish that config file. And we'll go and take a look at it. So as you can see, it is right here. This is pretty cool. If you wanted to create the users, then you can toggle it on and off here by saying, yes, we want to create the users. Why don't let that be the first thing that I do? And as you can see here, it is truncating the tables by default. We have a super admin. It comes with some information in here for some different role types. And these are the permissions that it is giving to those roles. And it has a nice little map down here where you can add, create, read, update, delete. And then that's what you're attaching to those permissions. Right? The permissions are going to be created. You're going to attach them using this. When they print, they're going to be something like, since this one has R for read, U for update, then the name of the permission is going to be read profile, update profile. Same thing for users, create profile, read profile, or sorry, create users, read users, etc. And these are the role names that are going to be the bigger house for this, so to speak. And that's pretty much it. We will come and make changes in here in a bit, but what I want to do is run our migrations just to see what we have. Well, actually, what I do need to do is call this new seeder. This is the Lara Trust seeder. I need to call it in the database seeder so that it can do that. I'm going to comment these out for now. And in here to call that seeder, I'm just going to do this. Call Lara Trust seeder class. So now we can run the migration. I'm doing fresh because I don't remember if I have any data in the database. So I'm just going to do that just so it clears everything out from scratch. And then it's going to also, in the same command, seed the database with the new seeder that we have. As you can see here, it has dropped all the tables. It has created new tables. It has added that Lara Trust setup tables that we were able to get from running the configuration commands. And as you can see here, these are the inline commands that I was showing you in the configuration file where it says creating permission to delete for users, creating role. And it did that for all of those roles that we had in that config file, as well as the permissions. It just looped over everything. I do need to change up the app name in my database, but in my MySQL GUI here. But for now, it just says Laravel. These are the migrations that we just ran. As you can see, we have users here. We have four of them, super admin, admin, user, and then this random role name thing. In this package, the default is app.com. It's perfectly fine, but the password is also password in here. As you can see here, we have roles. These are the role names. This is a display name, description, created at, updated at, etc. Then we also have a role user table, which is basically just a relational database that tells you that the user model is attached to this role ID and the user ID, and that's what's connecting them. We also have the permissions table, which is basically a list of all of our permissions that we created. One thing that I do want to change here is if you can see where it says the name of the permission, it says users read or users update. That's fine, but I think it's going to be a little bit more readable for us if we were to put it the opposite way. So read users, update users. At least for me, that works a lot better. We'll fix that in a bit, but for now, that's just what we have going on here as our default. The display name is fine, read payments. There's also a description built into this migration, which is pretty cool. And then we also have a permission user table, which we don't have anything set up for that yet, but we do have it accessible. And then we have a permission role table. And as you can see, permission ID, role ID, this is the relational database, the pivot table that is connecting those two things. I think that's pretty much it for what we have here. That's fine. So let's go back, let's make some tweaks, and let's make this exactly how I want it to be. Let's get out of here. Let's go to that Lara Trust. I believe it was Cedar. That's the config file. And let's make the changes that I want to make. Instead of super administrator here, I'm going to make it super dash admin. We can get rid of this. We don't have any payments, but for now, everything else can stay the same. To access our users, we have create, read, update, delete. That's the exact same as the default. We can leave the rest to do that. And for the profile, we can also read, update. We don't have this really hooked up in our project, but I'm just going to leave it here just so that you can make the tweaks that you want to make. And the same thing for here. I just wanted to change this administrator to admin. The profile and the users can stay the exact same because for me, I'd like to have the admin and the super admin have the same roles and permissions. That's just my particular preference. You don't have to do it this way. This is just the way that I prefer to do it. The next thing that I want to do is I want to get rid of this role name. Well, actually, I'll keep it here just so that you can have it for reference, but it's not really going to mean anything for our purposes. But there are two more roles that I want to have. The first one here is going to be moderator. And the moderator won't have as much power as everyone else. When it comes to the users, I just want the moderator to be able to read the users, right? I don't want them to be able to create them. I don't want them to be able to update or any sort of interactivity with them. For instance, if you have a project and someone emails or whatever to us, the moderator is perfectly capable of looking up any information just to confirm or to answer any questions in that way, but they're not actually able to make any changes to that user. They'll just be able to pass it up to either the admin or the super admin. So just kind of think about it like that. You really can't go wrong. That's just my thought process when I'm doing these things. You can do whatever you want to do, like I said, but if you're following along, this is how I'm setting it up. The next role is going to be the developer. Now, this developer, I don't want them to have anything to do with the users. I don't want them to see them. I don't want them to interact with them. I don't want to have them do anything in relation to anything with the users. I just want to set it up so that they can access a profile And if we had pages or anything that the developer is allowed to do, then they can do that. But for now, I'm going to keep it as default with the profile. And I get a lot of questions about, well, why do you set it up this way? Well, I set it up this way because this is a tutorial and a course. The object is to show you how different things work with different things so that you can see things a lot more clear. If all of our roles were allowed to do everything, then I'm not actually showing you what it means to give a role a permission or a user a permission or anything like that. I'm just basically letting it be a free-for-all. And this is what I'm showing you how to do because you can make the decisions based on your projects. Because don't forget, I don't work on your projects, right? I don't work on your team. I am not a part of your team. I am just a weirdo on the internet showing you a bunch of different things. Just basically take it and use it how you want to use it. Let's go ahead and also work on the cedar so that we can get those changes that I said I wanted to make before with changing the order of the names and dealing with that. Let's see. Now, I think the role was fine. It was just the permission that I wanted to change. To do that, all I really want to do is just change this. The permission value will be before what the module is, and the module is just what's coming from the config file. I think that that's good. Everything else is pretty much going to stay the same. The role is going to sync these permissions, and then it's going to use the users that we have in that config file because we did say yes, create users, and it's going to create those users, and then it's going to add the role of whatever the roles are that are coming from that Lara Trust Cedar config file. All right, so let's run this again. Let's check the database. So I should be able to just go ahead and refresh this, and maybe not. Let me close out some of these. Refresh that, and it should be in the permissions. Great. So permissions, the name now says create, read, update, delete, and it has the CRUD basically in front, and then whatever the model is, and that's going to look a lot better for us. Great. So now we have some data to work with, and we are working right through this. If you're enjoying the content, please go ahead and click that like button as it really does help out the channel. Here's a video YouTube thinks you'll like, and here's a playlist to follow along. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.